thank you very much to be here. I'm looking forward to meet you all. And I want to talk about something which I know that we all are very interested in. It is actually making statistics. When you go out in the world outside, there are a lot of people who don't care. But we care, and I think that that is what unites us here today. Me and Lars want to tell you about experience of coordination. I will start by talking about experience from Denmark, and Lars will continue with our experience from the EU, because we now have been a member many years, and there we have a lot of coordination. But before starting with my presentation, I just want to stop up and say why. Why actually are we talking about this? This, as you have heard, this is a headline. Why should we coordinate? Why isn't it enough that Israeli Statistic Institute are making their statistics in their house, and you are making your statistics in your house, and you're in your house? Why should we meet, and why shall we coordinate? And I think the important part is that we are not making statistics for ourselves. We are making statistics for our users. And our users, they should not care anything who actually makes the statistics. And that is why we as producer of statistics has this task, that it's not enough that we make statistics for our own, we have to make it for our users. So I think that is why we all are gathered here today. But I would start to present, first talk about a little bit about Statistics Denmark, so you better know the background, where we come from and why we have the attitude as we have, and therefore you always have to go back to where you come from. And I come from Denmark, and I come in this case also from Statistics Denmark. Statistics Denmark is, of course, as any other public institutions, we have a law. And we have a law for Statistics Denmark which actually is from 1966, and it has only been minor changes in it. So it's a long period we have had this law. Actually, when Lars will tell you later that maybe we'll have to change our law next year or next year again, and that will be a big task. But in this law, it was thought in the middle of the 60s, it was said that Statistics Denmark shall be established as the central authority for Statistics Denmark. So in that way, we are defined to be the organization who makes the statistics in Denmark. But there is also a subsection 3 saying that if other statistics are collected by another authority, then they shall inform Statistics Denmark of it, and then to make sure that we can cooperate of it. I will say that this paragraph has not been so much used. Because when one time, and maybe it's because of an old law, when you make a law, you have a lot of intentions, and then you start working, and then maybe you sometimes forget it. So I would say that this has not been used so much. But not to say that it isn't important, because it is important. Oh, that was the wrong. Other way. Okay, I'll learn it, maybe. But the other part is that we were also asked to, we were asked to talk about our system, but also our official statistics. So there I also sat and thought, what can I say about this item called official statistics? Because in Denmark, we don't have an actual definition of official statistics. As you see, Statistics Denmark is a central institution, and then the law says that we shall collect, process, and publish statistical information on social and economic conditions. So in that way, we have a law who is saying that we are the central, and our mandate, I would say, is very, very broad. So in that way, we actually could make everything. As I come back to later, we don't do everything, but we do most of what you could say the important statistics concerning social and economic conditions. So in that way, you can say that we are a highly centralized system. We are an independent institution. We have a board which decides our work program. We are part of the Ministry of Interior and Economics, and we have only one location. And this is the nice building you are looking at the end. Now I have this, so I cannot point to you where my office is, but this is where we are sitting every day. It is, now you cannot see it. Yesterday we showed it, and someone asked, are there windows in the building? And I would say, there is windows, but it is made, some is calling actually the prison or the factory of statistics. But that is where we, in north of Copenhagen. Of course, our law is also giving us the possibility to make data collection. Without data, no statistics. So all public authorities, they have to give information to us what they are possessing. And private firms, they have to give us information when we ask for it. So, the areas where we can ask the private firm is actually defined in the law. But that is the frame for us. Oh, I did not learn it this time. I try. And this is how we are organized. As I said before, we are part of Ministry of Economic and Internal Affairs. And that means that they decide our annual budget. And the minister has the parliamentary responsibility. So if there are some citizens who don't like how we are behaving, who think that we are asking for more information than they want to give us, and or we are doing it in a wrong way, then they can write letters to the ministry, the minister, and then of course we help her to answer it. Then we have a board of directors, and this board is the way that we define our independence, because we have a board which actually approve the budget and they decide on our annual work plan. So in that way, the board decides what content we make statistics of, the statistics we make. It is not the ministry who decides that. The board has, the chairman is our national statistician, and our national statistician is also the director, the general director for Statistics Denmark. And then we have 6 members, and in the law it is said that they should have insight into social and economic conditions. So in that way it's also very broad. But for the moment we have a couple from the research, we have some from the business sector, we have some from the local communities. So in that way we are trying to cover the whole society by 6 people. That's not always easy. Yes, our national statistician, he is also director general, and he is the manager of Statistics Denmark, and he's our boss. He's appointed by the Queen, but the minister is telling her what she should decide. So in that way, we make sure that everything is fine. Actually, the Queen has also decided that we are directors, but she has also been helped in that, I think. Then the board may establish advisory committees. And at present, we have 9 advisory committees. And I think it is not coordination of producing statistics which are going on there. It is more coordination or cooperation with our users which are going on in these advisory committees. But they can, of course, advise the board to take up new areas, to ask to change some statistics. So that is the reason for that. Then when I read the law, and it's always a good chance to be more knowledgeable about our own institution, is when I prepare for going for international consulting, because suddenly I actually found a paragraph 5 which I did not know existed. And that is because it has not been used. But it has actually something to do with the subject here, because in Article 5 it is said that the minister may establish a committee for cooperation between Statistics Denmark and other public authorities and institutions. But this has never been used, and it could actually have been a good idea to use it. That was what I was going to tell you about my institution. The next two slides, it will more be about what is asked for us when we are producing statistics. And one, it has been discussed not only here, not only in my home, but it has actually been discussed at worldwide level. So in 94 in UN, they decided some fundamental principles of official statistics. And afterwards, in 2005, in Europe, we decided the code of practice. And I would say that the content of the code of practice and the fundamental principles are much in the same way. In Europe, the history behind the European code of practice was that there was a country who had not behaved well, you can say, by not making impartial statistics. So therefore, it was important for the statistical system in Europe to say, you can believe in us. We are making impartial, we are making good statistics, which you can rely on. So the code of practice is covering 15 principles. And I've just taken some of the important part here, independence and impartiality. We shall have a mandate for data collection when we are statistical institutions. We shall, as producers, take a commitment to quality. We shall be user-friendly. We shall, when doing our job, we shall take care not to give more burden for our data providers than is necessary, because we do bother the people. We have to accept that. But we, of course, should take care not to bother them more than needed. Then confidentiality. We have to take care of the data we get to make statistics. The data providers shall be sure that we are actually behaving so that that this information is not giving back. And then, of course, accuracy, reliability, and timeliness. But I think that if you could say it, the goal for every statistical system should be credibility. I think that is the headline for what we are doing. Because if no one believes, or you can say, as I've said on the positive way, statistics are valuable, and it's only valuable when everybody believes that they are credible. Because otherwise, no one will use it. And therefore, the statistics must be impartial objective. Therefore, we have to be independent. As we are making statistics, this is, of course, I've said, the National Statistical Institute, but you are producing statistics in your areas. You also, when you're doing it, if it should be have the credibility, you should also be independent of political interests. It should, of course, be reliable. So if we are making errors, and there I have to say that we are making errors, all of us. When we are making errors, we shall be quick to correct it to the public. We shall say, okay, these figures we made a terrible mistake. We'll try not to do that mistake again. That is all we can do, but we shall react. We shall release dates. We shall tell the public when will we release data. Because in that way you could say that the production of statistics are independent of political interests. So therefore, a release calendar is very important. Statistics should be available to all users, not only the minister at the same time. We should use sound standards, methodology, and definitions on international standards. And information on individual persons and businesses shall be treated with confidentiality. I think this is some of the sentences which are telling that we are credible as statistics producers. So even if we have different systems in every country, and I can tell you in Europe, all countries have different systems. Some systems are looking more like it than others, but there are very, very many differences. And as I've told you, in Denmark, we have a highly centralized system. In another country, UK, they have a highly decentralized system, or in US they have a very decentralized system. But, and of course, if it is an integrated system, making, using international standard, making integrated statistics, it is much easier when you are an institution. But you should not forget that even in an institution, it is also, you also have to fight for not having a lot of pipe stove. So therefore, it's always a fight to make sure that the statistics are integrated. But of course, in a decentralized system, the same goal, I think, is there, that you should coordinate surveys, you should coordinate statistical standards and methods, dissemination and metadata. But of course, it can be more difficult. So therefore, you have to be active, you have to have cooperation agreements, you have to make meeting arrangements and practical cooperation. But now I will turn to, if I can do it, to some of the examples of where we have coordination in Denmark. Because as I said, we are centralized, so we are producing statistics for most areas, but there are some areas, and I've tried to take the most important parts here. So we are not responsible for statistics in the area of health, environment, energy, financial statistics, fishery, and of course there are some minor areas which also are part. And for each of these statistics, we are having different coordination. If you first talk about the financial statistics, there we have always, the central bank has always been a statistics producer, like Statistics Denmark, and we have had some cooperation in different areas. But in 2000, it became clear, it was after at the time when the euro was introduced and the European Central Bank was established. Then it was obvious for both Statistics Denmark and the Central Bank that we needed to be more firm in our cooperation. We needed to be more precise who made what, who was responsible for what, which institution was responsible for the international community. So therefore, we had to set down and divide what to do. So therefore, we made a framework agreement. And in this framework agreement, there is an organizational structure. So we have a main committee, and we are meeting once, mostly twice a year. And we have subcommittees in different areas which are working in without, yes, you can say automatically they are. And as I also said, that we have a high contact between people working in Statistics Denmark and in the bank concerning coordination of the subjects. And we are cooperating about concepts, methods, because we are working after the same international manuals. We're working after the ESA, the European Statistical System for National Accounts. We are working on the balance of payment manual. So in that way, we are making sure that we are making statistics on the same international standards. We are exchanging microdata, so the bank are responsible for all the primary statistics on financial institutions. So they collect the data and then they give the data to us so that we can make national account figures on these areas. And on the other hand, we are also giving them the business register. They are having, I think every week, they're getting a copy of our business register in order that they can use our business register in their frame. But I would say that this cooperation is, of course, when you have very close cooperation as we have here, it's also, there's also some discussions, because something like a business register is it's a very, in the statistics Denmark, you have a business register for all companies in Denmark. So you have some ways to handle this. In the central bank, they are very interested in the financial institution, and this is a very small area of the all institutions. So in that way, they have a much more, you can say, knowledge about these institutions, which are in the big business register. So therefore, there can be tensions, but we are trying to keep up and to have meetings to make sure that the cooperation is good, because they learn from us and we learn from them. So therefore, it is an important cooperation. We actually also have cooperation concerning dissemination of statistics. In that way, that when the central bank is disseminating their statistics on their website, they are also putting statistics in our data bank. So if you want to know something about financial institutions as a user, you go just to the statistics bank in Statistics Denmark, and then you go to the financial area, then you get figures. You can see on the tables that it is, the data is coming from the central bank. They have their logo on it. But otherwise, it is just like other areas. So I really think that we have a good cooperation there. Concerning the environment and energy area, I've put them together because they are actually in two different ministries. But we have made a committee, and it was only last year I made this committee in Statistics Denmark in order to try to build up a cooperation between the producers of the environment and energy statistics and Statistics Denmark. We have, of course, some cooperation on the basic level. We know we have a better cooperation with the energy statistics, because that is actually in one big area of the Ministry of Climate. They have one big section there, so it's easier to have cooperation. Energy statistics, the environment statistics, is spread in a lot of institutions. So there I am eager to hear how you are cooperating, because I am not satisfied with the way we are cooperating in this area. But I hope we will do it better, but I really want to use some efforts in this, because when we come to the European coordination, we actually will in higher and higher degree have a responsibility for this cooperation. So this area is not functioning as I would like it to be. And in a way, I'm not sure the health statistics, I think that in a way it's maybe it's a bit different, because we know who actually are making the health statistics, because it's also the one institute in the Ministry of Health. But we don't, for the moment, we don't have so much formal contacts, and I don't think that we have any agreements. And so in that way, we also are working in this area to make a better cooperation. The last area is fishery. And there we actually also have a nice, good cooperation. We have framework agreement and we have good cooperation. So in that way, we have made some of the same kind of organization behind our cooperation. So for my conclusion in this area, I would say that for a cooperation to be successful on the basic statistics production, then the top managers in both organizations, not only in the statistics bureau, but also the top of the institutions where you are belonging, they should be committed, both of them, to cooperate. And they should make sure that you make a written agreement telling why are we cooperating, what are we cooperating about, and how are we cooperating. And I think a meeting structure is very important, because the everyday coordination is always working well, but sometimes suddenly we don't, it is not working, and then it is important that there are a structure for the next level to go in and to make sure that the cooperation in future will be much better. But the important is it. So, thank you. I will stop and then Lars will continue with EU.